Friends, we are passing through a very crucial period of the Earth's history. Who to blame? Being a student of botany, a plant science, I have always taught my students about the invasive species like Lantana, Eichhornia, which have invaded our areas, affected our biodiversity, and created problems. Over the years, now I feel that the most devastating and destructive invasive species is the human being. Wherever we went, we created destruction. Is it possible to stop it? COVID-19 has done a great deal. Anyway, but this tells me that at least what we can do at our local level. We believe in a dictum which say, think globally, act locally. What one can do locally in his own house, everyone can afford to do agriculture. Those who have a good yard or a good balcony may have certain plans, but at least each and every one can do one thing, and that is sprouting the beans. Almost all the beans which we can use as a food material, they can sprout very well in a small plot or in a small pot, which may be sitting near the balcony or near the window or near your kitchen window. And then within a few days, it will sprout, and then that will add to the oxygen in your house, maybe in a small way, but it's a good production, and you can have a green vegetable produced by yourself. That is one.
Namaste, I am Kamlesh Yagnik, Chairman of Sarvajanik Education Society, which is catering to the academic need of 32,000 students of Surat and South Gujarat. Today, we are observing Earth Day. This is the 50th anniversary, and this year's theme is Climate Action. Any action which results in combating climate change is a climate action. We all have experienced climate change in terms of either temperature change or a precipitation change. As a chairman of Sarvajanik Education Society, I make it a point to go to Sarvajanik Education campus on my own bicycle, which has resulted in many students and staff following me, and they also have started coming on bicycle, which results into overall reduction of GHG emission gases. Today on this occasion, I appeal everyone to refrain using their private vehicles and come either on the bicycle or use any public transportation going to their workplace. I appeal everyone to do something, and I especially compliment Srushti and Samasti for taking this great initiative. I compliment and give my best wishes to both of them. Thank you very much.
Namaste. I am Dr. Vikas Desai, public health expert working in Surat since last 50 years, and in last 10 years I have been working as a director of Urban Health and Climate Resilience Center of Excellence, which is an initiative of Surat Municipal Corporation. Please accept my greetings on Earth Day. We are celebrating Earth Day 2020 with a theme of climate action. Climate change affects different aspects of life. Health is one of the outcomes. But health is more appealing argument for climate change for administrators as well as community. Climate change as a natural process is a slow process. But human activities have enhanced this process. Extreme climate events or consequences are usually followed by human and economic welfare both before that of the climate resilience. Climate change is more discussed worldwide. For last two decades, it is part of Sustainable Development Goal. If you look at all 17 goals of the SDG, all are directly or indirectly contributing to climate action, which is goal 13. Climate change and corona, let us think in terms of the current scenario. Can there be any relation between two? Climate change is frequently described as a threat multiplier. Something that exacerbates existing problems and creates new ones. In terms of health, it either brings resurgence of infections which are already forgotten, or it brings new infections. No aspect of life on this planet has been untouched by climate change, and viruses cannot be exception. So though there is no direct link established as of now between climate change and coronavirus, viruses are influenced by climate change. What impact is coronavirus having on world's climate? This is another side of the coronavirus. Coronavirus brought the lockdown, slowing down of life in cities. And we read, we hear, and we see on TV programs that skies have turned blue, the canal water is clean, the air quality is improved, which we can see on the air quality applications. And these changes have been brought by what? Grounded flights, reduced local transportation, shutting down of the factories, maybe slowing down the activities, human activities in the cities. The lessons the pandemic is teaching us about living with nature and generating evidence of benefits of climate resilience. Climate resilience for current generation was not more than an imagination. But now there is a proof in front of them that climate change is a reality and we can make a difference. It is also expected that coronavirus pandemic shall lead to a deeper understanding of the ties on a global scale. Well-resourced healthcare systems, essential for health security threats, including that of climate change, and the support to the economy which shall promote health, equity and environmental protection. All these are very important and valid for the survival of the earth and climate action. Climate action for Surat can be post-corona, review of urban planning with climate focus, review of urban planning with the local social demographic characteristics, ensure enforcement in interest of climate, health and economy, educate people for climate forecast, health, personal protection and resilience, engage people in climate resilience for safe housing, safe environment, safe transport, green city and preventive health. 2010 onwards, Surat Municipal Corporation have taken several measures in terms of the engineering measures or the activities of the city, leading to clean Surat, green Surat, using alternative energy sources and water recycling. Surat Municipal Corporation was also under Rockefeller Foundation project between 2010 to 2016, under Climate Change Trust, Urban Health and Climate Resilience Project and 100 Resilience City. Surat is smart city. Surat has now the new initiative, which is Urban Health and Climate Resilience Center of Excellence, which is researching, training, advocating and creating network for the climate resilience and health. It also works through Blue Child Friendly City for inclusion of children and adolescents in climate resilience. Cities should aim at climate and health focus in every planning, multi-stakeholder involvement, joint trainings, promoting learners network for evidence-based advocacy, planning and monitoring. And who are these learners? They are the academicians, researchers, trainers. Ensuring interdepartmental convergence and encourage doers, that is administrators and decision makers, to adopt joint climate and health focused strategies.